Hello everyone, my name is Gabrielle Hossein. International Women's Day is important for a wide range of reasons. It's a day to remind ourselves of the history of women's struggle for greater justice and to recommit to that struggle regionally, nationally, internationally, for all the women and girls whose lives are still defined by inequalities and the intersection of those inequalities with race, class, disability, sexual orientation, and more. It's a day to remind ourselves of the connections among gender justice, climate justice, and economic justice. And it's a day to continue to envision and honor and strengthen that vision and a sense of joy, hope, inclusivity, and collectively. Ultimately, International Women's Day is the one day that the global feminist movement, which is the only movement to have prioritized women's rights and empowerment, says we are still here, and we are. In all our complexity, in all our fierceness, and in our dream for a more peaceful, sustainable, caring, and just world. It's also important to know that International Women's Day has been celebrated for more than 100 years and comes out of a socialist tradition led by working class women organizing around securing labor rights as well as rights to fair wages, rights to safety in the workplace, and we see so many of those issues still relevant today. We stand in support with domestic workers and right they have to access justice through the Industrial Relations Act and the Industrial Relations Court. We stand in solidarity with women who want to end sexual harassment in the workplace. And we stand in solidarity with those movements that insist that women's care responsibilities, that the care labor that they put in, and that the ways that those unequal responsibilities affect their right to a livelihood must be addressed. We need to keep in mind that International Women's Day was first celebrated in 1958 in a march organized by Christina Lewis in San Fernando, and so we walk in a long tradition of fearless women today. In my own experience, I have spent 25 years in the Caribbean feminist movement, being mentored by an amazing range of women from so many Caribbean countries. And what I would say to young women, finding those who can mentor you, finding women who can mentor you, finding women whose work you admire, whose leadership you admire, whose humanity and humility you admire, and seeing if those women can mentor you in your journey. To me, mentorship has given me my greatest set of skills, has honed my political analysis, my absolute solidarities, and has given me the skills to do so many things, from writing press releases, to organizing marches, to fundraising, to teaching, to doing research, to mentoring others, to just everything. And finding that intergenerational connection that has always been so key to women's knowing and to women's power and to women's networks. And if I had to give advice to young women, I would say, don't go out there alone. Every cub needs her pride of lionesses around her. And that is what has helped me over 25 years. That's what I want the Institute for Gender and Development Studies to be able to provide for a younger generation of feminist women and men. And that, I think, will be your greatest source of power. If you can find mentors, that's the best advice I can give, to be able to navigate a very complex, very difficult, unjust world. Speaking as somebody who every day struggles to forgive myself for all the things that I haven't accomplished, I must say that I want to honor the fact that so many women are doing their best. They're the ones holding everything together on every front. And just to say that maybe we got to stop aiming for balance. I think we have to remind ourselves that women are in fact carrying the unequal burden of care in homes, in families, for the elderly, for the sick, for the aged, for children. And just keep in mind, we are having to do double in every sphere, at every turn. perform emotional labor, perform unremunerated labor, invisible labor, on top of many times also earning a livelihood. You know, we have to perform the planning labor. We have to, you know, remember all the details for everyone. And so I don't know if there's balance in a world where we are carrying so much for everyone. I know for me, I have a 10-year-old daughter, and some days I don't spend enough time with her. And some days I don't, if I spend more time with her, I don't spend enough time on my job. And some days I don't spend enough time with my mom. And some days I don't spend enough time with my friends. And some days I probably don't even spend enough time for me. The lesson is we just forgive ourselves every day for not meeting the demands for us to achieve that mythical balance, or indeed to get everything right. It's very clear from all the data that COVID has definitely increased unemployment among women. It's created greater financial dependency on men. It's caused a reassertion of traditional gender roles and responsibilities, particularly in the household. It has burdened women with more hours of care responsibilities and household labor than before. And there are higher levels of depression and greater vulnerability to sexual and domestic violence. These are just the realities that we're aware of. Women were already clustered in the lowest paid sectors of the economy and the most precarious and informal jobs. And we remain excluded from leadership and decision-making in politics, business, and religion, sites of power and influence, which are dominated by men. We have to insist that 50% on boards is what we are aiming for and what we are certainly qualified for. We have to insist that 30% in parliament is absolutely simply not enough. Women have been dominated tertiary education in the Caribbean for more than 20 years. They cannot possibly say we are not qualified. Among ourselves, we also need to make room for working class women to lead and not just see them as beneficiaries of welfare or charity, but be clear that these are women who are exercising leadership in their own communities and that we have to honor and support that. And that's what solidarity across class means. And that, you know, that we build women at every level, at every class. And for me, that's something we have to always keep in mind, always challenge ourselves to do, is to work across class, across race, across religion, across gender and across sexuality, and to honor those women and their leadership who are often least given a chance to lead. My name is Gabrielle Hossain, and together with Soroptimist International of Esperance, I choose to challenge you to understand, join, and continue to strengthen Caribbean feminism's vision for peace and justice, women's rights, and empowerment. Let us create fearlessly and unapologetically a much more just world.